and I'm the Social Planning and Research Council in Hamilton, and I'm also a parishioner at St. Joseph's Catholic Church on Long Street. And I am the chair of the Hamilton Faith Communities in Action, along with Sarah Quinta from the Diocese of Hamilton, the Catholic Diocese. And so, anyway, I'm here because I want to lay a few ground rules for what's about to happen. It says I'm the moderator, so that means I lay down a few of these rules, and we'll see how it goes. If it goes well, you won't see me again tonight. I'll just be sitting in the front row smiling and praying and doing whatever we're all supposed to be wanting to do out of our hearts. If it doesn't go well, I'll be out here yanking people down. This is a tight prayer agenda, so we hope all the gods are listening. So in a minute, we will be welcomed officially. And the program, I've decided, is just going to turn over as it turns over. I'm not coming up in between each of these things. So I'm asking you as participants, because I haven't met all the musicians or people participating tonight, but I'm asking you and kind of warning you about how tough I can be to really follow that little schedule I sent out before about time. And so when Rabbi Hillel is finished welcoming us, then Yvonne's just going to come up and do what's next. Then I'm not going to come up. And then Aiden's just going to come up, and so on and so forth. So that's very easy. And I want to say that we're going to be here for a while, and that we are here for a really important reason. And it takes time. Today in the world, already again today, in England, you know, it was one more reason. And I'm sure in many, many countries, there were other things that didn't make the top of the news. And I'm sure that some of us today didn't feel peace in our hearts at some point, even on an individual level. And so there are all kinds of ways to be here tonight to offer prayers for peace and nonviolence, starting with our own personal stance from nonviolence and moving to why we're here in terms of our faith communities, and specifically to pray for peace and nonviolence around that. You'll recall probably that we're here because a hate crime report came out from the Hamilton police, and it had some stats in that about hate crimes toward religious communities, amongst others. And that's one reason that we're here. We're here because a whole bunch of faith leaders had the courage to come together around one issue at City Hall, around the inclusion of trans and gender non-binary people, and from that was a groundswell, really, through an invitation from Rabbi Hillel to say, what else can we do? We're engaged in this. There must be a way we can make other positive changes in our community, and that's why you're here today. So the name that we are here to speak tonight through all our prayer is peace. And it takes a very long time to tell our name. We'll be probably almost 2 hours telling our name to ourselves from different perspectives and praying that name outward, asking for a change, a transformation in our community around peace. The thing is, there's no break, no intermission. If you have to get up and go and do something, stretch, relax for a minute in another place and come back, we'll still be here telling our name to ourselves and praying that name of peace aloud through song and word and ritual. And so please feel free to do that. Take care of your needs and be attentive to what we're doing here. I hope I don't see you for 2 hours.
Place of worship, a place of prayer for all nations, and it is an honor and a privilege for Beth Jacob Synagogue to be hosting this interfaith multicultural event tonight, The Blessing of Coexistence. Under that title, The Blessing of Coexistence, we want to remind all of ourselves that coexistence is not an imperative, it's not something that we tolerate, something that we have no choice but to suffer through, but rather it is a blessing. We want that. We want us to be different, and we want to celebrate that difference. We don't need to look for the commonalities between us. We don't need to compare our religions and say, you believe that, I believe that too. It's enough that we're human beings, and that we're alive, and that we're here to share this country. That's enough for us to all live together in peace and harmony and helping each other out when the other one needs that. So it's an honor to be here tonight. Thank you all for coming. Thank you to all the religious and other leaders who helped organize this event and make it this success tonight. And I hope and pray that this is the beginning of a new beginning of good for all of us, and that this event is also the beginning of many more good events celebrating together here in Hamilton. Thank you very much.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me if I speak from here? If I hide behind here, you won't see me. You just can look around like that. The blessing of coexistence, just the title alone, for Aboriginal people, you know, that's a statement from day one. Coexistence. Coexistence in the sense that when the visitors come to our land or came to our land, right? So we've been coexisting for over 500 years, right? So, very honored again to be here to say a prayer. I also want to acknowledge the territorial lands that you're on. We're on the New Credit Six Nations lands. Actually, Six Nations Reserve is only about a half hour drive away from here, which is one of the largest native reserves going. So anytime that you feel really energetic and want to see another side of people, I would say take that journey, go out there and check it out. So again, I'm here to say a prayer, and not only to mention the lands that you're on, but also the prayer in the sense of, like I mentioned in the beginning, the coexistence. We have something called the two-row Mohawk belt. So when the visitors, and that's what we call people, we call you some visitors, because, you know, coming into the land, there was something actually in place with our people where, I think I just go to my prayer. I'd like to thank the Creator for all that we have, for the food we eat, the water we drink, the air we breathe, and the land we walk on. Creator, I pray to you this day to give thanks to everything we hold dear and precious to our hearts, Creator. We thank you for this beautiful day, this day of life, this day of living. And for this we pray and we give thanks. We give thanks, Creator, to Brother Sun, who rises each day to give us light, warmth, and energy. And for this we pray and we give thanks to Brother Sun. We give thanks, Creator, to the north, the south, the east, and the west winds, as they blow in illusions to bring the clear air, the rains, and the snows, to replenish Mother Earth. And for this too, Creator, we pray and we give thanks. We give thanks, Creator, to the nighttime sky and wrap of the moon and stars above as she looks after the women, the children, of Mother Earth herself. For this too, Creator, we pray and we give thanks. And we give thanks, Creator, from the smallest of seeds to the tallest of trees as you provide us nourishment, medicines, and shelter. For this too, Creator, we pray and we give thanks. And we give thanks, Creator, to the two-leggeds, the four-leggeds, the six-leggeds, the eight-leggeds, the swimmers, the flyers, the crawlers, for all the creatures you place before us, Creator, we pray and we give thanks for those creatures. And we pray and give thanks, Creator, for those who have passed on, passed over to the eye, our ancestors, our loved ones, those who have left this world and journeyed to the next, we pray for their well-being of spirit and mind as they make that journey to the other side. For this too, Creator, we pray and we give thanks. And Creator, I ask that you look after all the people under this roof. You keep them of good heart, of good mind, and on a good journey and on a good road. This too I ask in your name. And we ask for the ability to receive thy blessings so we can pass it on to others who come our way. Help us to help those around us. Help us to be a good people of good heart, and that we share and care about each other, for we are human beings. So this too, Creator, I ask in your name. Niao. Niao means thank you. And I just want to make mention as part of this prayer is the things that we look at. When we pray, in the sense of not what to pray for, like you want something, it's to be thankful for what we have. So that prayer I just said is based on the Thanksgiving address for Aboriginal people. Those are the things that we need to be thankful for on a daily basis. So yes, we get up in the morning, we pray, we'll smudge. This is my eagle feather, which was given to me by my mother. This is my feather case, which was given to me by my mother. So in a way, this is my Bible. This is my Bible in the sense of where I come from and what I do. I had people ask me if I was going to do a smudge, and no, I was not prepared for that. But I'm hoping that these words that I bring to you, that they'll put you in a good way to start. I also would like to say something to the kids that are in the second row. Hey guys, I'm talking to you. Yeah. One thing I always do when I'm talking, and I do my prayer, because one thing that we always try to look at is the generations to come. These guys are the next generation. You're the younger generation. You will be taking over this place in time. And the thing that I will say to you, though, as people out there, and we need to think of those upcoming generations, think about this. Does the air need us? No. Does the water need us? No. Does the plants need us? No. Do the animals need us? No. But think about it. We need every one of those to survive. So, let's hope that the next generation will inherit a positive earth and full of people that are human beings. Because it's not just people. When you take in all these things and our beliefs, and we all have those similar beliefs, you know, we need to be looking out for those next generations. And I think that's what this is about, too, is the coming together. The idea of peace and coexistence. As Aboriginal people, we've had to do this for 500 years. So now we're asking, you have to do it, too. Thank you.
Thank you so much to Yvonne, who does not count herself as an elder in our First Nations community, but is considered an elder by so many of us. Thank you. And it is a privilege to bring greetings from Mayor Fred Eisenberger and City Council for the City of Hamilton to this unique and beautiful gathering on, as Yvonne mentioned, the traditional lands of diverse First Nations, including the Anishinaabe and the Haudenosaunee, and particularly including those diverse First Nations Two-Spirit people. It was a great privilege to be one of the seed planters of the plant or the tree that is yielding part of its fruit tonight in this gathering. The first seed planter who brought us this beautiful gathering tonight was a transgender woman whose name is legally anonymized. In October of 2015, this woman attempted to use the female bathroom at McNabb Bus Terminal, our municipal bus terminal in downtown. She had a negative experience with a city staff member attempting to use the female bathroom, and her response was to exercise her right to take legal action against the city of Hamilton. She demanded that her right to equality as a transgender woman be respected. My privilege was in participating in crafting the settlement that the city reached with this woman. And part of the settlement was the transgender and gender nonconformity protocol. This protocol was passed into city law on International Women's Day, March the 8th, just the week before last week. The protocol commits the city of Hamilton to fully and robustly protecting and respecting the rights of transgender and gender nonconformist people. It is a great breakthrough in law and in policy that was described in the Globe and Mail for a national newspaper as being on the cutting edge of human rights policy. The transgender protocol makes Hamilton the first city in the world to adopt a city policy that defines in detail the city's obligations to transgender people and the rights of transgender people vis municipal services. It secures the right to exist in public, the right to basic safety and basic dignity for transgender people. That is the nature of the breakthrough. 2 days before council's vote, we had a beautiful meeting at City Hall in which 34 delegations from the community addressed us on the meaning of the transgender protocol, what it meant for each individual speaker. And as I say, 34 individuals and sometimes groups came forward to share thoughts. Very sadly, 4 of the delegations were anti-transgender, and they presented arguments that were offensive to the dignity and equality of our transgender citizens. The beautiful news, and the saving news, if you will, is that 30 of the delegations, the vast majority, were voices of love and voices of peace. It did my Irish Catholic heart good to see such a huge, such a juicy, multi-faith delegation address City Council. And I won't list all the denominations, but the sheer diversity and plethora of faith groups that came forward was inspiring not only to me, but to a vast, and I use that word in a non-hyperbolic way, a vast number of people who have spoken to me on a daily basis since that March 6th meeting, particularly members of the transgender community, expressing what that day meant to them. To hear the Torah, to hear the Bible, to hear our diverse ethical traditions and religious traditions invoked specifically so as to affirm transgender equality, to correct a festering social injustice. It was a deep and authentic moment of reconciliation and a deep and authentic moment of peace and healing. And it made me so proud to be an Hamiltonian. The truth is, I'm still riding the high. I thank everyone for that day. Shalom, salam, namaste. See you in the future. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. It does my heart good to see such a great turnout here tonight for such an important gathering and information sharing. My name is Dan Kinsella, and I'm the Deputy Chief of Community Policing for the Hamilton Police Service. I'm just going to talk just a couple comments about peace and some of the things that it means to me and others that I know. Peace is a fundamental asset to community building, to personal growth, and ultimately to the survival of our planet. At the heart of many faiths, practices, and cultures, advancing a peaceful coexistence is essential to ensuring productive, meaningful lives and sustainable societies. We need to do this to keep going. We talked a little bit about survival earlier. It underlies our quality of life and the ever-changing fabric of our communities. We're constantly changing, we're constantly evolving. We've got to keep up. Peace is both an inner journey and an outward commitment to live in mutual benefit and respect with our communities and in turn our world. In order to foster agreement and harmony, other concepts must be embedded into the community. These include fairness, justice, inclusivity, and human rights. Peace enriches our communities and individual lives. It sets a positive environment for us to embrace diversity and support one another through caring and generosity. In peace, we provide a cornerstone for attaining a sustainable, meaningful, vibrant and fulfilling community and eternal personal life, fulfilling personal life. We must be vigilant in our quest for peace and work with all communities, such as we are this evening. It is vital to all of us to be inclusive and to listen. We need to listen to the voices in our community as we work towards a goal of peace. Thank you for allowing me to come tonight and represent the police force.
My name is Colin. I'm the cantorial soloist at Temple Anshe Shalom. At Temple Anshe Shalom, we do a lot of music, and we wanted to pick something tonight that was universal, that could really speak to everyone. You'll find the words on the second page of your program. We believe that to have peace, it's important to be open, to open our eyes to everything around us, to everyone around us, to open our hands to give to others, to open our lips to share conversation and build relationships, and to open our hearts to the love that's possible.
Open my eyes to truth, open my hands to give freely, open my lips to good words, to pure words, open my heart to love. Open my eyes to truth, open my hands to give freely, open my lips to good words, to pure words, open my heart to love. Open my eyes to truth, open my hands to give freely, open my lips to good words, to pure words, open my heart to love. Open, 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 open my
Tonight, we gather as people of faith, representing many diverse paths to the sacred, to affirm our mutual belief in the inherent worth and dignity of every person. Like a beautiful bouquet of flowers, we each bring the unique beauty of our faith to this time of mutual witness and shared hope. I'm Reverend Victoria Ingram of the First Unitarian Church of Hamilton, one of the many temples, congregations, sacred circles, churches, mosques, meeting houses, sweat lodges, synagogues, and places of worship that serve this diverse city. Working together, we have created this opportunity to demonstrate that we can choose love, not fear, respect, not bigotry, and working together harmoniously and collaboratively, and not toiling away in isolation. One of the ancestors of my faith wrote, "We need not think alike to love alike." And while it may be true that we don't worship in the same ways, or we don't call on the mercy of the same gods, or maybe we don't even revere a god at all, and yet we can still sit at the same table. We can share similar dreams of safety and peace for ourselves and for our children. And we can affirm each other's right to exist and be respected. When one or another of our community has their worth questioned or their safety threatened, we, as people of faith, must reach out to one another, and we need to offer our compassion, our solidarity, and our support. We must send a clear message that we will not accept a climate of fear, ignorance, or intimidation to define our city, must work together to ensure that love prevails. This evening we share with you a celebration from the Unitarian tradition, a flower communion that is our way to represent our collective beauty and our individual uniqueness that are integral parts of the interconnected web of which we all find our existence. Tonight, our faith communities bring their offerings of flowers to this common gathering, each beautiful, each unique, and each joining in the bouquet of our gathering to create beauty in our diversity. So if you are a faith leader who is holding on to a stem of flowers, will you please come on up front? And as you are placing them, I will read the list of faith communities that are here this evening placing their flowers. Amongst this group are Bishop Michael Berg from the Diocese of Niagara, Monsignor Murray Kretsch and Sarah Ginta of the Diocese of Hamilton, Imam Hussam Hillel of the Muslim Association of Hamilton, Sister Nancy Sullivan of the Sisters of St. Joseph, Canada, Rabbi Jordan Cohen, Temple Anshe Shalom, Hussein Hamdani and Uzma Qureshi are here from the Muslim Council of Greater Hamilton. Barb Babi from the Hamilton Jewish Federation is here. Reverend Ian Sloan of the United Church of Canada and Lorna McQueen, also of the United Church of Canada. Rabbi Hillel Lavery Israeli from Beth Jacob Synagogue. Nick DeConing, who's with the Ontario English Catholic Teachers Association. Judith Dworkin from McMaster Hillel, the Jewish Students Organization, Autumn Getty, the Mennonite community, and Beverly Shepherd, also of the Mennonite community, and last but certainly not least, Colonel Bob Ward with the Salvation Army. Please join me in a moment of prayer. Infinite Spirit of Life, we ask your blessing on these, your messengers of fellowship and love. May they remind us, amid diversities of knowledge and gifts, to be one in desire, affection, and devotion to your holy will. May they also remind us of the value of comradeship, of doing and sharing alike. May we cherish friendship as one of your most precious gifts. May we not let our awareness of another's talents discourage us or sully our relationship. May we realize that whatever we can do, great or small, the efforts of all of us are needed to do your work in this world. In the name of Providence, which implants in the seed the future of the tree and in the hearts of each of us a longing to live in love, let us renew in this time our sincere resolution to be colleagues to one another. In this holy resolution, may we be strengthened, knowing that we are all family, that one spirit, the spirit of love, unites us, and may we endeavor for a more perfect and a more joyful life. Amen, and blessed be.
with you. My name is Peter Wall. I'm the rector of Christ's Church Cathedral on James Street North and the dean of the Diocese of Niagara. Don't let the word keynote put you off. I want to add my thanks and the thanks of all those of us who were involved in the planning of this event to our Rabbi Hillel for his wonderful and gracious welcome to this place. And to thank you all for being here to express solidarity and hope and faith. We gather tonight as citizens of this great city to mark and celebrate the blessing of coexistence. So I want to talk a little about a blessing, and I want to talk a little about the city of Hamilton. The Oxford English Dictionary defines blessing as a declaration, invocation, or bestowal of divine favor. And all of the traditions from which we come, even if that is no tradition, would value the truth of that statement. That a blessing is a declaration, an invocation, or a bestowal of divine favor. It is a measure of the work that was done together and to which others have referred earlier. Muslim, Jew, Christian, Aboriginal, First Nation, LGBTQ2, on the Trans Protocol that brought us to this place. As the group that worked on that important work did their work, we learned together. As we learned together, we became a blessing together. And so on this night, and in this city, and in our lives, as we learn together, we learn to work together. And as we learn and work together, we become a blessing together for each other. So a little story. 19 years ago, I moved to Hamilton. In the church, one is moved. So I was coming to Hamilton, and like a lot of Ontario kids, nobody ever wanted to live in Hamilton. Hamilton was the place you drove by. You didn't have to stop. I didn't know anything about it, and I was ashamed at the ripe old age, whatever I was then, to really have never spent much time in this city. And they didn't know what to expect. But I had lived and worked in Sudbury and in Windsor, both good training grounds for Hamilton. Sudbury and Windsor are both honest, diverse, gritty, working class places. And I use all of those adjectives as very, very positive attributes. And so I came to a city that was first and foremost welcoming. A city which has always been generous. It's a place that has been welcoming for all of its history, for people from around the world. People who some might describe as different, but whom we would describe as neighbor. It is a city which has built itself on hard and honest work. And in that hard and honest work, it's built diverse and comfortable communities, in which a great industry thrived and flourished for many years, and a city in which changing realities called for changing responses. A city in which the overwhelming presence of primary manufacturing industries has, through innovation, research, and dedication, become a presence for excellence in healthcare, in education, in port services, and in the arts. It is a city known throughout this country for its generous response to community needs, for its way of taking care of our neighbors, to being good citizens. It is, in so many ways, as folks remind us, Ontario's best kept and most precious secret. It is also a city which, even in these past months, has proven to be a welcoming place and a blessed home for those who had no home, who had no country, who felt bereft of blessings. A declaration, invocation, or bestowal of divine favor. Is it a perfect place? No. Do we get everything right every time? No. Are there still moments and places where things that should not happen do happen? Yes. Are there still situations in which we devoutly wish to be more welcoming, more accepting, less judgmental, more justice-bearing, and more peacemaking? Absolutely. But look around yourself tonight. Turn in your seats and see your neighbor. Say hello. The more we know each other, the less we fear things about each other. The more we commit ourselves, even if at times it feels somewhat untested or untried. The more we commit ourselves to walking together, to upholding each other, to celebrating the differences between us as gift and not as problem, the more we can indeed live in peaceful and mutually fruitful and blessed coexistence. We all want, of course, to continue to appreciate the distinct and varied cultures, belief systems, faiths, and traditions that belong to each of us because of our religion, our race, our ethnic and cultural background, our orientation, and our preferences. But we also know, we really know, that the sharing of the riches of our own many and varied traditions makes us all better. We are blessed because we can be a blessing. And without appreciating and embracing those special qualities that are mine, combined with the special qualities that are yours, there cannot be an effective nor liberating ours. The impetus for this gathering this night came from a group of people working together on something else, on a matter of fundamental justice and inclusion, which marks our city as a leader not only in Canada, but in the world. Because that group of people came together and worked well and hard, which motivated them all. It is really a simple next step to gather here tonight to be thankful for those gifts of passion and determination and to declare to each other and through each other to all others that the blessing of coexistence, that declaration, invocation, and bestowal of divine favor strengthens each one of us. Strengthens us to seek friendship and common goals rather than exclusive separation. Strengthens us to get to know and learn about each other. Strengthens us indeed to rejoice in each other rather than to judge or dismiss or write each other off. That goodness that mystical coexistence in peace and harmony will seem at times elusive. It will at times be hard to achieve and to hold on to. It does and will continue to require of us our very best. I believe, and so must you, by your very presence here, that it is not only much more than worth it, it is irreducibly the very least that we can do. A declaration, an invocation, a bestowal of divine favor. How good and pleasant it is to be here among friends, among brothers, and among sisters. May that divine favor be upon each one of us, on all those whom we love and serve, and on all of our city this night and in the days ahead.
Peace be to your hearts. Make peace reign in your walls, in your palaces, peace. For love of my kindred and friends, I say peace upon you. For love of the house of the Lord, I will ask for your good. For love of the house of the Lord, I will ask for your shalom.
We will then proceed into a longer period of silence, during which you will be invited to compose a prayer.
Our prayers this day, everyone, are focused on the blessings of coexistence. When you think of the strength of the diversity of our various spirits, what does your heart give thanks?
So on that index card that we madly made sure you had as you arrived, we will invite you to write 1 to 10 words, or you may simply draw a picture. And we will then invite you to share that prayer with a neighbor, hopefully someone you do not yet know. And once you both had the chance to share each other's prayer, we will invite you to exchange cards with one another so that you may carry that person's prayer home with you.
Let us gather our hearts together. Let us pray. Blessing, coexistence, creation.
Creator, how can we be anything but grateful? You who opened our eyes to see beauty. You who opened our hearts to feel joy. You who love us into being that we might flourish into richness of life.
Blessing, coexistence, creation.
We long to know you more closely, for in that knowing, we may find peace. In that knowing, we might find comfort. In that knowing, we might feel secure in your love found in all of creation.
Blessing, coexistence, creation.
You of many names, create within us the yearning to recognize your grace and your wisdom through the lives of our neighbors, that together we might celebrate this vibrant, fragrant, multi-hued bouquet you call life. Let us know and be known.
Blessing. Coexistence, creation.
We invite you now in the silence to craft your prayer. Take a minute or two to do so. Now from that deep and sacred space in which an image or thought arose, please share this with one person near you, hopefully again someone you do not know. Exchange your cards with one another.
And when your sharing is complete, everyone, and you exchange the cards with someone else, please then sit in silence until all other exchanges are complete. Please share your words.
Sound of one who made
Salam, salam alaikum, shalom, peace and blessings upon everybody here. It is a privilege and a humbling opportunity to be standing next to you tonight. This is my first time in the synagogue, so I'm very happy to be here. Although I did go to a high school that was predominantly Russian Jewish, but I never was invited, so I'm very happy that I finally received an invitation, so thank you. I never sought to be invited, let's say that. I would like to begin with the opening prayer from the Quran, and just before I do that, when I did go to my Russian high school, I was invited during graduation to recite this same prayer. And when I did, I remember two rabbis came and said to me, it sounds very similar to something that we would recite, that we would read. We have a lot in common, and it depends on the context of where you are, the socioeconomic context, the geographical context, the political situation. A lot of, again, interaction between peoples will depend on that. And I just want to begin by sharing one story with you, and this story really touches me. Because I come from Egypt, and when I went back a few years ago, a Coptic Christian brother came to me, my age, and said to me, here's 100,000 Egyptian pounds, it's yours. Like, what is this for? He says, well, your grandfather lended or gave money, this exact amount of money, to my grandfather. But my grandfather could not pay your grandfather. So he left it in his will for his son, who was my father, to pay it back to your father, but he couldn't. So he left it in my will, or in his will, for me. You get the point, right? Yes. Long story short, he's like, here, this is the money that, you know, you're owed. And I said to him, of course, this is what the Quran teaches us. Don't worry about it, it's fine. I wasn't coming to Egypt for 100,000 pounds. Even with the exchange rate, it's not going to be worth much anyway. It's okay. Right? Why am I, you know, highlighting or citing this story, brothers and sisters? Because oftentimes we forget that even in the Middle East, Christians, Jews, Muslims lived side by side for many, many centuries. I'm not talking about decades, we're talking about centuries. Yes, there were difficult times, but brothers and sisters have those moments too. Husband and wives take each other to court sometimes. It's the nature of humans. Humanity sometimes has its weaknesses and its strengths. And I believe that pure faith practiced from within here, understood properly in here, seeks to cultivate respect, reaching out, and understanding that we are going to be different. And there's a beautiful verse in the Quran, or ayah. Every part of the Quran is referred to as an ayah, which means a miracle. A miracle within the Quran, and it says, listen to these words carefully, Ya ayyuhan nas, O human beings, we have created you, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. We have created you from a male and a female. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلٍ. And then we have made you into various nations and tribes. We have made you into various nations and tribes. Why? So that you can say, hey, you stay in that corner and I stay in this corner. No. لِتَعَارَفُوا. So that you can come to know each other. I'm sure many of you have heard this ayah before. We are different. There is difference amongst us. There are certain things that, you know, you'll come to not really fully accept because of who you are, but it'll still, again, be an amazing part of you, that amazing compassion in you that comes up and says, hey, I may not agree with everything, but I can accept this person as he or she is. And I remember when I was, again, in Egypt, I was speaking to one of the Christian priests, and he told me something beautiful. He says to me, I don't believe in what you believe in, and I don't have to. And still have the sniffles. When you have people from every corner, I mean, I thought Canada was diverse. Canada's diverse, but still, you know, we don't get to see. In Mecca, you literally see everything. You see everything. And of course, when people from all around the world come, again, they also bring, you know, their, you know, things that we're, as Canadians, are not immune to. Anyway, so I'm going to begin with the opening prayer of the Quran, and I want you to listen with your heart.
There is a passage which is eloquent in its simplicity and dramatic in its power. God comes to Moses and instructs him to share with his brother Aaron and his sons, the high priest, the words that are to be used in blessing the people. 15 words. Prototype for all blessing. And in these words, as they're rendered in the Hebrew, are contained all of the things that we desire who are gathered here this evening for the well-being of our community. Kindness, graciousness, protection, favor, the prosperity, dignity, and above all, shalom, salam, peace. And in our rabbinic tradition, there is a story that the people objected that these words were being delivered to Aaron because they said, what man can deliver such blessings? Doesn't blessing come from the Creator? And the answer they received that God will be standing there. God will be standing next to the people who are saying the words. God is indeed the source of blessing, but we need to be the medium of blessing. We need to share, deliver, provide blessing with one another. And shalom, in its most literal sense, means wholeness or completion. And ultimately, I think that's what we need the most. A sense of wholeness from within, a sense of who each and every one of us are, but a wholeness that can then emanate outward and be shared with those around us. This evening, it is indeed my privilege, my blessing, to be able to share these words of blessing with you. And since we have gathered here this evening to stand together in unity, I'm going to ask you to actually stand together in unity to receive these traditional words. Yivarecha Rami Yishmarecha. May God bless you and keep you. May God look upon you with kindness and be gracious to you. May God show you favor and may God grant you the greatest gift of all, the gift of peace. Amen. And in our tradition, the community responds with words of blessing as well, which Rabbi Hillel will now lead us in song. Please be seated.
So if you haven't already done so, turn please to the back page of your pamphlet. I was sitting in my office 2 days ago, working together with our committee on putting together this evening, and I thought we need something special, special song for this evening. And I started going through my mind, going through our Siddur, our prayer book, and I found these words, which are traditionally said in the synagogue after the priestly blessing is pronounced in our prayers. And I started thinking about the words, and this melody came to my mind. And I sent it out to some friends to see if they wanted to learn it and join in. I guess they'll join in from their seats. I'm glad that Brother Peter is here, though. So here it goes. Thank you.
said you wouldn't see me again unless people didn't behave. And really, the timing was so tight, I had excluded my final call to action and closing remarks. But everyone was so fast, there's time for me for about half an hour now. And I really appreciate that. One of the things that I think saved time was that it was clear that this was a sacred space held in peace. Because although Andy and many others wanted to clap, didn't you? Many times, you held back. I think this is time for a collective clap for all of the people. Hamilton Faith Communities in Action. Sometimes we think differently about whether prayer is actually action. And I think it is. And it was a lot of action to pull this prayer together. We met last Wednesday for the first time. Prayer by committee. It was the best and funnest thing I've ever facilitated, and here are the results tonight. And I believe that the blessings are going to be abundant here. But what we're calling for going forward is more action. Some other things that we can do to ensure that our community is committed to what we have prayed about and what we have been about tonight. And so there is sufficient time when we conclude after Rabbi Hillel sends us forth to gather and eat, drink, and be merry, and plan action together. And if you don't know what that action is, then you contact me, Rabbi Hillel, other people that you know to say, how do we get involved? And then we'll tell you. We'll get all together again before next year. But we will do this again, because there will be a need for this again. So we'll take care of that, because that's what we do. I appreciate everyone who's here this evening and all of the leaders and gifts that came together. And I'm especially grateful for the divine guidance in all of us.
We're going to conclude tonight with the blowing of the shofar, which is a traditional Jewish call to action. It is a fulfillment of biblical verses that say, "V'chitavom yechama be'atzechem," when a war on trouble comes into your land, you're supposed to sound your horns, and God will remember you and you'll be saved from your enemies. But then on the day of your celebration, "V'yom simchatchem v'mo'adechem," then too you are to sound the horns and give your thanks to God Almighty, and God will give thanks for you also. So we're going to rise and hear the traditional sound of the shofar.